Hello, hello everybody, and welcome back to Simon Plays. I'm Simon, and today we're playing more Bloodborne. We're currently swimming in Bloodstone Shard, so we'll upgrade the spear too. And start using that, but... yeah, I think I'll still use the twin Bloodstone Shards here. And then we can do some gems, right? Oh yeah, that's quite a difference. 2%, 7%. Yeah, I don't think I have anything better. And I guess we can just equip what we have here. Yeah, sure.
Welcome. What? Very well.
We're gonna do this. Then we'll go back. Oh, come on. Why do I keep doing this? We're going back to the Cathedral Ward. On the last episode, we sent a couple of NPCs here. So on the previous episode, we sent a couple of NPCs here, so we should be getting some more dialogue.
Ah, oh, the Hunter. Thank you. So that old man, you told him about this place, right? Well, he don't offer me much in the way of conversation, but still, I'd rather see him alive anyhow. And I sort of hope that my asking you turn out to, you know, help him out in the end. I've never been any use to anyone, you see. Just happy about it, is all.
Right.
If you find any sane survivors, well, send them.
Oh, hello, dear.
Hello.
You weren't lying. This is a safe place. Thank you. I'm in your debt. I'd like to tender my thanks, but I haven't much to offer. All I can give is my blood. But would you even take a whore's blood?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, good. Come close, dear. Don't worry. This isn't the first time.
The blood of Arianna. Blood taken from Arianna, Cathedral Ward, Woman of Pleasure. The sweet blood of Arianna restores HP, blah blah. A member of the old healing church would know that her blood is similar to precisely what was once forbidden. And she wears the noble dress.
Oh, hello.
It's gold.
Sorry, dear.
Yeah, okay. She won't give you more blood unless you use it.
You!
Yes, she's still being fine with us.
Ah, you! The swindling offcomer. Did you really think that'd work? There's no fooling me.
Oh yeah, you're so smart.
Now, off with you. You heard me. Go away. I can't stand the stench of your lying breath. I'll spare you one nugget of advice. Beware the blind man. They're the beggar sits at the bottom of the bloody food chain. And then he's here acting like he owns the place. He's not to be trusted. What's he want with all those people anyway? That little weasel has a murky past, I'm telling you.
Oh, the great judge of character, huh?
I can't stand this.
Yeah. Now we're gonna go here again, and... Oh, what do you know? Because we opened all the Cathedral Ward doors.
Oh, hello there. Perfect timing. I must warn you not to go near the tomb below Erden Chapel in the Cathedral Ward. Hemwick, an old hunter, has gone mad. And he's my mark.
You get the shh.
Don't go near the tomb below Erden. I have business.
Okay, so there is some kind of trigger that blocks the lamp back at the Gascoigne boss, and you're supposed to then go there, but I cannot for the life of me find that trigger. It never happens, so as soon as I speak with her, I just go. And Henrik should be here, and as soon as we engage him, then Aileen should follow. Yeah, he's right over there. Now, I don't think I can backstab him, but I'll try. I think he's too smart for that. Yeah. Immediately. Oi. What is Aileen? Okay, Aileen is here, she will now probably aggro him. He will be able to backstab. Oh. If you beat Aileen once or twice, it's okay. Just don't keep smacking her. It's not gonna end well. Come on. You're too slow, mate. Attack faster. I guess. Okay, we can get the killing though. Got the air rune. We still can't use those, but we will soon. Girl, where are you going?
That wasn't necessary of you,
oh,
but you have
on.
My thanks. We made it with our lives. You're not bad at all. You must have killed Gascoigne as well, then.
Yep.
He was falling apart. I'm sure it had to be done. But try to keep your hands clean. A hunter should hunt beasts. Leave the hunting of hunters to me.
Okay. I don't think she has anything else to say. Yeah. And she's just gonna come up here and stand here. So that's done. We made sure we're not missing this. And now we can move on. And we have one more thing to do before we go for Amelia. I hope I'm saying her name right. But yeah, there's more to do. An entirely new area. To be precise, the Hemwick Charnel, I have no idea. Hemwick, whatever lane. You can summon this for the boss here. Henriette. Okay, so we're here. We're gonna go left. And follow the road. Now be very careful in this area up ahead, there is a lot of gunmen and dogs. You generally want to be aggressive against the dogs. Since they stagger easily. There is another dog back there waiting for him to shoot. Now, you wanna... You see him? I don't know if you can see him. He's right where my hat is showing. There is him, and there is another one behind that tree. And there is another one in the middle there. So you wanna rush across, kill this guy. Then we're gonna go kill him, but we're gonna be shot at, so don't stop moving. We're gonna be shot at from the left, most likely. Yep. Okay, there's two guys here, I think. Yep, yep, yep. One is here. The other one is here. You can kill him through the grave. Oh, come on. You don't even need to run around. And then there's a few guys in the middle there. We're gonna do the multiple backstab like we did to those other guys, hopefully. It doesn't always work because I have to walk in front of one of them. It's not gonna work here. We're just gonna hope that we hit as many of them as possible. Yeah, you have to be extremely careful here. You just need to get as many of them as possible before they start shooting at you. Because if you have four of them shooting at you, they can quote-unquote one-shot you. One attack from each. Okay. Even with us having dumped so much in vitality at this point, they still hit hard. There is another couple of dogs here with a shooter, a sniper. Oh, come on. We're gonna go here. And we made it to Hemwick. If you know how this is properly pronounced, let me know in the comments. This whole scene down here is inspired by a movie, but I cannot, for the life of me, now that it matters, remember the name of that movie. With the people dancing next to the burning corpses and stuff. These are not very dangerous, they're kinda a game. Not paying attention. There is a shortcut here, we don't have access to it yet. We need to bring the elevator down. We can grab the knowledge though and speak with this NPC here.
The graveyard murmurs. Then it's almost time. Oh, I can't wait. I just can't wait.
Right. I don't think she has anything else to say. Yep. Oops. Sure. And I think we can get some ritual material here. Yep, this is for the chalice rituals. Now here you need to be just a little bit careful. There is a one with fire bombs up there. She's hidden right now. And if you try to fight a dog and stuff, she's gonna start throwing fire bombs at you. Molotovs. So just come for here first. And then we can do these ones. Again, there is a Molotov lady up on that ledge there, so you want to pull the big guy back. Yeah, I don't like stairs. Come on. Easy peasy. Thank you for the blood vials. This door is locked, cannot be opened from this side. Don't drop anything, please. Thank you. We can go here to grab this. I guess I could have. Yeah, I could have come here earlier. But whatever. Okay. And. Oh wow, I hadn't seen this view before. Oh, that's the bridge. With the clock tower and stuff. Okay. Be careful here. Sneaky one. Sneaky, sneaky. There's another one. Oh, right. This is the one that doesn't really attack you, isn't it? Oh, no, it isn't. Maybe I killed it. There is one that doesn't attack you. Somewhere around here. I think it was one of those, but I killed it. I think that's the, yeah, that's the elevator. Pretty useless if you ask me, but... No, I guess I know why they did this. Wait, I'll show you. There is another very sneaky opponent here. You come up to these ledges, and they are scripted to push you, and you can fall to your death. So I guess that's why they... No. You didn't get to do that to me. Exude confidence. She's got molotovs, yep, so be careful. Now, want this. There's a dog somewhere in here. I think it's up there. Yeah, it's coming. Okay, guy that. Oh! I forgot about the one behind me. Actually started with me. Where did she come from? Oh, I can hear the guy. Where is he though? Oh, he's above me. And there is also a wandering nightmare above me. We'll try to get the nightmare and hopefully not die to the gunner. Okay, I have no idea what the gunner is. You can go back here first. This is the way back to the entrance. I think this is where that lady dropped from. Oh, hello. We can get a Madman's Knowledge here. An Adept Blood Gemstone. And some bullets. Oh no, what am I doing? I'm gonna fall now. Okay. And then we wanna go this way. Exit here. I think that's Kinhurst. The castle. Man, the architecture in this game. Just love how everything looks. You can see there is an item, it's a rune actually, the lake rune, right above the lake. Or some type of lake, there are a few lake runes. Don't remember which one this is. Now, careful here, don't rush ahead, there is a few enemies that can stunlock you if you're not careful. Come on. Come on, bro. You can do it. Oh. What the hell? Are you joking right now? Does not exude confidence. It's very annoying if she hits you, but she dies pretty easily. And there is a dog too. I think you can use the classic dog trick here and just stand next to the fire and... Oh! I actually meant to pull the dog, but you know. Completely invisible, I never saw her until she started moving. Blends in with the environment. Bloodborne is very busy. Sometimes hard to understand what you're looking at, especially after nighttime. Be careful here, she can grab you and do a lot of damage. And then we have to fight these guys, but technically if you want to be safe, you can come here first. Open the shortcut. And we can fight them now. Oh, come on. It very often happens with these guys that you get the visceral, but they attack you, they hit you as well, but you can usually regain by actually doing the visceral. Come on. Do something. Visceral, but I got it. Heavy blood gemstone. I think that's blunt attack or something. Doesn't really matter right now. There's a lot of dogs here. Be careful. Try not to pull all of them at once. I thought you saw me, but... Oh. No. You do not get to kill me. Oh no. Stuck on the body. Yeah. Damn dogs. Usually it's beneficial to trade with them, but not when there's so many. Because you can never trade with just one. Yeah, no. Oh, God. Oh. Oh, come on. I must be doing it on purpose at this point. This area is pretty chill, it's pretty easy. If you come later, there are some extra enemies, depending on how much inside you got. But at this point, it's pretty easy. And if you actually did the preset chalice dungeons before you came here that you've unlocked, it would be truly a walk in the park. So we got the lake rune. This transcription of the Great One's inhuman voices ripples like a watery reflection. This rune means lake, and those who memorize it enjoy reduced physical damage. Great volumes of water serve as a bulwark guarding sleep and an augur of the Eldritch truth. Overcome this hindrance and seek what is yours. Yeah. Lake. There's a lot of lake runes. They all have to do with different resistances. You have to be careful here as well, there is a gaggle of enemies coming down from the cabin or whatever. Oh. Oh. I done goofed. I got greedy. I thought for some reason I could... I knew better, but I thought I could kill them before they managed to attack. After getting the free Charizard too. The last Bloodborne game I played was an arcane build, and arcane does a lot of damage. A lot of damage. With R1 attacks, and I'm kinda used to that. I also did the Chalice Dungeons on that playthrough. So I was very strong when I got here. I'm pretty sure there's supposed to be a Wandering Nightmare in here. So if you don't know, what you can do is reload the game. And it should respawn the Wandering Nightmare, which doesn't exist, and it was all a fantasy. I was pretty sure. So these are the enemies that are gonna be spawning all over the place if you come here with higher insight. But for now, they are meaningless. You just walk away from them, you find the invisible lady with a million eyes, you chain backstab her if the game decides to work properly, and you kill her in one go. But it didn't work properly, so... Oh. Disgusting. There she is. Come on. Where are you? I know she's here somewhere. I saw her glow. Did she move away? Oh. Okay, and when you kill her, you didn't actually kill her. There will be a second one now. And essentially they both need to be dead at the same time for the fight to end. They will continuously respawn if you let them. But if both are dead at the same time, then it's done. Yep, I see her. Now you kinda need to... This seems very easy, I know. But you kinda need to be careful if she catches you with this when you are near here. Oh, like this? Like, look at this now. We are gonna die now. We are actually gonna die in the Witch of Hemwick now. You wanna roll away as fast as possible because she's gonna start doing some crazy AoE shit if you sit there. Okay, we didn't die in the Witch of Hemwick. Tragedy averted. Disgrace avoided. Oh, come on. No, that's the AoE thing. Sometimes she does it twice, and if she decides to do it twice, you're dead. And I should really stop talking and just play the game. Oh, come on, these guys. Move away, guys. Okay, at least we found a high health one. That's useful. Nice. I framed the crap spell. Oh. Yay! Disgrace averted. Gonna light this up. But don't leave yet. You need to come down here. And get the rune workshop tool. Runesmith Karel, student of Bergenworth, transcribed the inhuman utterings of the Great Ones into what are now called Karel runes. The hunter who retrieves this workshop tool can etch Karel runes into the mind to attain their wondrous strength. Provost Willem would have been proud of Karel's runes as they do not rely upon blood in any measure. So this guy must not have liked the old blood. And this is how we get to use runes. And here we can memorize. We've got three base ones, I guess, and then this one is for covenants. These are not all that great. We're gonna take this and try to kill all enemies with viscerals from here on out. We're gonna take this and yeah, some bullets. I mean, bullets and VLs are literally useless, right? But the rest are not that good. What we have right now available to us. We're gonna repair. We can, yeah, we can plus X this, which means we get another slot on it, and we can move the red blood gem here. Why not? Okay, we can. We also have this, but not very good right now. And then, yeah, this is strength scaling, the heavy blood one. And then this is thrust attack, which we do not need, but we can put the thrust attack here, since that's the only reason we're equipping that weapon, it's thrust attacks. And then, yeah, this slot is empty, so we might as well do this. And I guess we can do that. I mean, it doesn't really matter. In terms of Bloodstone shards and twin Bloodstone shards, you're gonna have a bazillion of them over time, so it doesn't really... Now, I don't remember if I've shown this. I think I haven't. You can come here and give to the messengers any of the accessories we found. I'll give them the errands, and they'll wear them on their heads. You can give them that. Different types of stuff you find. Now there's also gonna be, oops, I didn't mean to fall. There's gonna be Henrik's set here now, and you wanna pick it up. It has very good bolt resistance, which we are going to need. And then I don't think there's anything else we need here. We can level up.
Welcome home, good hunter. What is it you desire?
Yeah.
Very well.
Well, I guess. Yeah, it's starting to give 2 points per now. Oh wait, we have probably, I'd like to know how many in total. Oh, I also forgot to use the tear stone on the last episode because I panicked when I realized I was muted while talking to the doll. And I didn't use the tear stone she gave us. We can use that now. Tier blood gem, this is, I think, blood damage. Oh no, it's we continues to recover plus two, okay. Droplet. Whatever. So we're gonna
welcome. Very well.
Do this again. No. These are 1 point. Yeah, we'll go like this. And how long has it been? It's been 35 minutes.
Farewell,
I think we can
good
do
hunt. May you find your
well
worth in the waking world.
Yeah, we don't want anything else. We want to go back to the cathedral world. I only have one fire paper. Well, that's interesting. And now, this time, we're actually gonna go kill the boss. So easy to parry, I have no idea how I failed like that. It's so slow. You can see some statues that are pretty weird already on the outside. But then there's more of them here. Okay, so she's a higher member, a high ranking member of the healing church, turning into a whatever this is. This is one of those fights where you're better off not locking on most of the time. And she does stagger. Yeah, like this. Obviously takes a lot more damage if you hit her on the face. She's very weak to fire and also serrated because she's a beast, so our cleaver is doing wonders here. Wow, how is this? Right. So she dropped this pendant of the Vicar Amelia, used to change into a blood gem which fortifies weapons. This pendant, passed down among the Vicars who head the Healing Church, is a reminder of the cautionary adage. To reveal the adage, touch the altar skull. We're gonna use this. Get our gold blood gems. Not very useful, I don't think. Yeah, attack various beasts up. It's very specific. I mean, it can be very good, but also very useless sometimes. Now, you need to use this. You remember, we need to find the secret password, the adage, and we can use this to do that, but this progresses time and it changes a few stuff. So do not do that yet. Go back to the Hunter's Dream and I will see you on the next episode. Thank you for joining me. Remember to leave a like and subscribe if you're enjoying the series, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.